Hi guys, I'm back. You're watching India Today Tech. I am Bhavni Jain and this is the full review of Redmi K20. Because there are not major differences between the two phones launched by Xiaomi K series, Redmi K20 and Redmi K20 Pro, I am going to talk about Redmi K20 simultaneously. And since you know my way, this is the full review. I am going to divide this video into 5 different categories: design, display, cameras, performance and battery. Let me also share with you guys, if you have any questions regarding any of these phones after you finish watching this video, you can put your doubts and comments in the comment section down below and I'm here to answer. Now without any further delay, let's get into the video. Let's begin with the color gradients. Both the Redmi K20 and Redmi K20 Pro comes in 3 color gradients: flame red, glacier blue and carbon black. I don't have the flame red one, but I have carbon black and glacier blue. Let me also tell you that this carbon black is for the Redmi K20 Pro and I have the glacier blue with the Redmi K20. So speaking of the gradients, so I think flame red and glacier blue are two gradients which are very distinctive from what we usually get in the market. But these wouldn't be my preference. These phones are quite flashy. I would rather go with carbon black, which looks more sophisticated and it comes with Kevlar pattern. Yeah, so carbon black is my choice. Since we're talking about the design, let me also tell you a little bit more about these phones, in the sense what is placed where. So on the right side of the frame, you get 2 buttons. One is of course the power key and the other one is long volume key. On the left side of the frame, there is nothing as such, so it's very neat and clean. On the bottom of these phones, you get a pin port to eject the SIM tray. So in the SIM tray, you can put 2 nano SIM cards. Next to the SIM tray, you get a Type-C port, a microphone and a single speaker grill. So let me tell you, the volume is really nice with this speaker. I liked it. And basically, I think you don't get a 3.5mm headphone jack with this phone.
Pavni, did you even check the top of the phone?
So as I was saying, I don't think so. 3.5mm headphone jack will be missing in Redmi K20 Pro or Redmi K20. After all, these are the alpha flagship device of Xiaomi. So yes, on the top, you get a pop-up selfie camera. And next to the pop-up selfie camera, you also get a 3.5mm headphone jack. Well, this makes me happy because there are a lot of flagship devices coming these days without this little convenience. It's good because it's difficult for me to remember to carry 3.5mm to Type-C dongle all the time with my phone. Speaking of the front and back of these phones, the phone looks really pretty. So I think let me just put a light colored wallpaper of one of these phones to show you guys how thin the bezels are on these phones. Yeah, here you go. So the bezels are really, really thin on both of these phones. These smartphones come with 3D curved Corning Gorilla Glass 5 at the back and front. With aluminium frame, these phones look really nice. The back of the phone is neatly designed. There are just rear cameras placed vertically and just a logo. Here's one more thing about these two phones. The Redmi K series phones doesn't come with IP rating. It is said to be splash proof due to its P2I coating. K20 and K20 Pro comes with AMOLED display and Xiaomi likes to call it Horizon AMOLED display. These phones feature a 6.39 inches full HD plus display. I use the Redmi K20 Pro to browse social media apps like Twitter, Facebook and Instagram. To watch videos on YouTube, yeah, I watch Mr. Bean again. And to play games as well. In almost all scenarios, the Redmi K20 Pro offers great viewing angles. The colors are punchy and I didn't have to manage the brightness level manually even at once. As for unlocking the device, these smartphones come with in-display fingerprint sensor and AI face unlock. With every phone, you know, I like to use fingerprint sensor rather than face unlock. So the in-display fingerprint sensor on both of these phones are quite fast. I really like it. Both the Redmi K series phones come with 4 cameras in total. One of them is the front facing camera, which is the pop-up camera, and the other 3 are the rear cameras. Yes, K20 and K20 Pro comes with triple camera setup at the back. The front facing camera has got 20 megapixel image sensor and it has also got the lighting on its side, which looks really attractive. The 3 rear cameras have 48 megapixel Sony IMX586 image sensor, 13 megapixel wide angle lens and an 8 megapixel telephoto lens. Time to make a note here. So this is the first big difference between these two phones. Redmi K20 also comes with triple camera setup at the back, but the image sensor used in the primary camera of this phone is Sony IMX582 instead of Sony IMX586. Coming to the quality of the photos taken from these phones, the pictures look really crisp, vibrant, and the details are captured so well. Even the portrait mode works really well too. And the same goes the telephoto lens. But the selfie cameras of these phones perform okay-ish. You know, with 20 megapixel image sensor, you expect the phone to click some amazing selfies. But the front-facing camera of Redmi K20 and Redmi K20 Pro is just satisfactory. Now I think it's time when I should show you guys a few shots that I have clicked with the phones so that you can decide if you like the quality of the pictures. Redmi K20 Pro comes with Snapdragon 855 chipset, and this is the second difference between these two phones. As mentioned, K20 Pro comes with 855 chipset, but Redmi K20 comes with Snapdragon 730 chipset. Both these phones run on MIUI 10 based on Android 9 Pie. MIUI offers option between navigation keys and gestures. The app's drawer is also a good thing to see here. It comes with a search bar that makes it easy for the users to find the apps they are looking for. The MIUI brings features like anti-flicker mode, reading mode, second space, dual apps, among other things. One thing that I disliked about the phones is the pre-installed third-party applications. But anyway, I want to make a point here regarding the haptic feedback. The sense of touch of these two phones is really smooth and nice. The vibration of the keys isn't too loud, and I really like that. Redmi K20 Pro features 4000mAh battery, and it comes with 18W charger in the box. But the good part is this phone also supports 27W fast charging, and Xiaomi selling that separately. But let me also tell you that with 18W charging system, this phone easily lasts one whole day on a single charge. So am I recommending this phone? Well, let's count the pros once again. Looks? Check. Glass body? Check. Amazing color gradients? Check. Narrow bezels? Check. Fingerprint sensor? Check. Powerful chipset? Check. Bigger battery? Check. Cameras? Asterisk. Wait, why? As mentioned earlier, Redmi K20 Pro comes with triple camera setup and a front-facing camera to click selfies. The front camera isn't that great despite having a 20 megapixel image sensor. But I'm not saying it's bad, but it isn't as good as it should have been. Otherwise, honestly, Redmi K20 Pro and Redmi K20 are good phones that come as a great smartphone package when it comes to specs and features. Redmi K20 Pro comes in two variants, 6GB of RAM with 128GB of internal storage and 8GB of RAM with 256GB of internal storage. Redmi K20 also comes in two variants, 6GB of RAM with 64GB of internal storage and 6GB of RAM with 128GB of internal storage. So if you're willing to buy Redmi phones on these prices, which are right now stated somewhere here or here on the screen, go ahead and buy it. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, you know what to do next. Hit the like button, share it with your friends, families, relatives, pets, and yes, pretty much with everybody, and subscribe to India Today Tech.